You know, one thing that excites me is that the taboo has really been broken about talking about spiritual issues. We just never broached the idea of immortality or eternality in medical school. But real doctors just didn't go there.
Yeah.
Well, they're going there these days. And it's all for the better. I say it's about time.
Dr. Larry Dossey is an American physician, health educator, and author of several best-selling books on the role of prayer in medicine. He is one of the pioneering figures in the U.S. who has helped to introduce spirituality into the general discourse about health and Western medicine. He lectures throughout the United States and has appeared on widely viewed television programs such as The Oprah Winfrey Show. In our episode last week, Dr. Dossey spoke of his conception of there being three eras of Western medicine. The first, Era 1 medicine, was practiced prior to the 1940s, with no discussion of consciousness or spirituality. Era 2 medicine came after the 1940s and recognized that one's mind, in this case meaning emotions, thoughts, and so on, can influence the overall health of one's own body. Era 3 medicine is, as Dr. Dossey puts it, non-local medicine. In other words, it encompasses the idea that one person's thoughts and prayers can heal another's illness.
So, what would you envision an Era 3 doctor being like in a hospital or in their practice?
Yeah. A decent doctor needs to combine all the eras, 1, 2, and 3. You know, I wouldn't want a physician to take out my appendix just on the basis of an Era 3 kind of awareness. Mm. I want a great technician. I'd want an Era 1 doctor who was just absolutely superb, who really did know the ins and outs of surgery and the use of medication. We should demand that from our doctors. That's basic competence that has to be there. Also, I would want a physician to understand that my own emotions and attitudes influence my healing. I mean, that's fundamental these days. That's the mind-body connection.
Yeah.
But I would also want that doctor to be able to freely use his or her own intentions on my behalf. Healing intentions, whether it's prayer or secular well-wishing for my mm-hmm. welfare, because research confirms this, that those things make a huge difference.
Yeah.
That's the Era 3 component. It's really not radical. Many doctors use this Era 3 factor anyway, unconsciously,
yeah.
not even realizing that they're doing it. And I'm sure that before I even was keen on these ideas, I saw physicians doing that unconsciously, and I usually call them superb physicians.
Yeah.
Their patients just got out of the hospital quicker. They just never developed complications. And these were what we call, you know, the good doctors.
Yes, yeah.
You know, and we didn't know what they were doing. Now we have a way of understanding some of their superb accomplishments as
yes.
physicians.
Dr. Dossey related how physicians in the U.S. have incorporated Era 3 medicine into their practice.
Are there any hospitals or any large projects that you see that are really incorporating this on a large scale?
Yeah, there are. There are programs within hospitals where nurses and even physicians will gather just for silent meditation for all the patients that they will see that day.
Oh, wonderful.
I'm in communication with doctors all over the country who tell me how they have constructed their own personal, private rituals using their own thoughts and healing intentions on behalf mm-hmm. of the patients they're about to operate on, for example. There's one famous plastic surgeon I know in the Atlanta area, and before she begins to operate on a patient who, for example, in the emergency room, she closes the curtains and she does a healing on the patient through her own thoughts and her prayers before she ever picks up the scalpel.
Mm.
And she has trained her nurses in the operating room to do exactly the same thing. with their intentions while she's going through the surgical procedure.
Some physicians are telling their patients before they see them that they plan to incorporate prayer into the treatment.
I have a friend who is deceased now, but who was a well-known internist in Santa Fe, Dr. Tony Rippo. He developed a little handout that he had his receptionist give to every patient who came into his office. And it simply said, I have reviewed all of the evidence for prayer and healing. As your physician, I think prayer might be of benefit. And as your doctor, I choose to pray for you. However, if you do not want me to pray for you, just sign the sheet, give it back to the receptionist, and I won't add you to my prayer list. He did this over many years. And would you guess how many people signed the sheet?
I was going to just ask. None.
None. Nobody declined prayer.
We will return shortly with more from our interview with Dr. Larry Dossey here on Supreme Master Television.
It was the biggest race of the year. And no matter what, I was going to win. Sometimes things happen you just can't explain.
Whoa, I believe there are angels among us.
And some things are more important than winning.
Sing down to us from somewhere up above. They come to you and me.
I don't remember who won the race that day.
Hours to show us how to live.
I'll never forget how I felt.
Teach us how to give, to guide us.
Including others. Pass it on. A message from the Foundation for a Better Life.
Welcome back to Science and Spirituality. Dr. Larry Dossey is an American physician who has extensively studied the interaction of the mind and the body in the realm of health, as well as the power of prayer and its ability to heal. He has conducted research at Princeton University on the topic and found scientific evidence that prayer can impact events occurring even at a great distance away.
One of the key contributions of these prayer healing studies is that this can be done in almost a secular way. It need not be any particular religious tradition.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a huge amount of flexibility. I mean, this umbrella is very large. This tent is huge, and I think most caring physicians can find a place where they can be comfortable and use healing intentions, regardless of what they call it.
This is your most recent book, The Extraordinary Healing Power of Ordinary Things.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us a little bit about what you have in here.
I just think that there's another side to healing that we've forgotten, and it's the power of really simple, ordinary things to make huge contributions to our health. I start the book, for example, with the power of optimism.
Mm.
People generally think that optimism is just a feeling, you know, it floats around in your head, above your clavicles. But if you really look at the research looking at optimism now, you can find that a sense of optimism is hugely correlated with good health, or absence of disease, and increased longevity. People who are pessimistic don't live as long as optimists, and they're unhealthier in the process. So if you're picking, you ought to go with optimism. It's a huge factor for good health and longevity. People who want to move toward optimism can do so. There are teaching programs that have clearly documented this possibility in adults, college students, and children. Anybody can become more optimistic.
We asked Dr. Dossey his opinion on what the results are when the focus of prayer is shifted from healing of an individual to the healing of the planet.
We've been talking about prayer in relation to healing. On a larger level, praying for peace, praying for our planet, it would seem that you could easily make the jump from here to there, that it would work the same way.
It's not a huge leap. You know, the original etymology of the word healing is gets to the word wholeness. the wholeness of the earth is being sundered now. And so the very essence of the fundamental notions of ecology have to do with wholeness. And so healing and wholeness and holy all come from the same root word. Healing, holy, wholeness. You draw a circle around that and you can call the whole thing a sense of sacredness. It may be that idea of sacredness is the only thing that's going to save us as a species. It'll come as no shock to your viewers to know that we face challenges that are monumental, that human race has never been saddled with before in terms of enormity. I'm not sure that we can intellectualize our way out of this, because without a sense of sacredness and a sense of universal connectivity between us and all else, I do not think that we're going to be up to the challenge. So I think that this sense of sacredness has a huge element of urgency to it.
Is there anything you'd like to tell our viewers about prayer or about anything that you might have on your minds?
Well, I think viewers really should give consideration to the information showing clearly that our consciousness is not just confined to our own brain and body. It can operate remotely in the world, outside of our physical organism, as we clearly see in these healing studies. And I want people to begin to ask, what difference does it make for the way I live my life and my understanding of what happens to me after I die? And we have the great good fortune to be living in a time where we have more information with which to deal with these eternal questions of our origins and our destiny than people have ever had before. So this ought to make us quite bold and courageous in how we approach these old questions of who we are and how we're related not just to one another as human beings, but to every other life form on Earth.
Dr. Larry Dossey, we deeply thank you for sharing your perspectives on prayer and its immense benefits in the field of medicine. Furthermore, we appreciate your heartfelt concern and encouragement for the world's citizens to return to a sense of sacredness as the future direction of our beloved planet is being shaped by members of the collective global family at this most critical time. We wish you heaven's great blessings in your noble work and life. Friends, we are gladdened that you could join us for this edition of Science and Spirituality on Supreme Master Television. Please stay tuned for words of wisdom after noteworthy news. Wishing you and those around you the best of health, peace, and happiness always.